Hi everyone, this is Venkat Narayana from Sunya Technologies. Today I am going to discuss public access modifier in C#. This is continuation to previous video, part 36, private access modifier in C#. Please go through previous video before going through this video. What are access modifiers? Access modifiers will provide accessibility of all types and type members. Here we are going to discuss public access modifier. If we declare any type or type member as public, then the type or member can be accessed by any other code in the same assembly or another assembly that references it. For example, here we have assembly 1, assembly 2. Assembly is in the form exe or dll file. This assembly contains multiple classes like class 1, class 2, class 3, and assembly 2 contains class 1, class 2, class 3. Here class 1 contains one field. This field declared as a public. If we declare field as public, then that field we can access within this class or other classes or other classes from other namespace or other classes from other assembly. That means if we declare any member as public, then we can access that member anywhere within the assembly or other assemblies. We don't have any restrictions for public members. We'll discuss this concept using Visual Studio. Launch Visual Studio and create C# console application. Here, create a class, class point. This class contains two variables, public int x, public int y. Here we declare two fields with public access modifier. Now we need to access these members. We can access within the class or other classes from other assembly. Now we'll access these members within the class. Here declare a method, public void test. Create an object for point class, point p equal to new point p dot. Here we are able to access x and y. How we can access means these are public. Public members can be accessed within the class. Now we'll try to access these public members outside the class, that means from program class. Here create an object for point class, point p equal to new point p dot. Here we are able to access x and y. Here x and y are public, so we can access these members outside the class. Here 10 p dot y equal to 20. Console.writeline x p dot x y p dot y. We'll debug this program. Put breakpoint here, F11. Here we create object for point class and assigning values. Here p dot x default value 0, we're assigning 10. Here p dot x is equal to 10, p dot y is equal to 20, and printing the output. Here output is x 10, y is equal to 20. Now we'll try to access these public members from other namespace. Here these two classes comes under C# tutorial namespace. Now we'll create another namespace. Here namespace 10. We will create one class, class sample, and create a method, public void test. Here point comes under C# tutorial and sample comes under namespace n, so both are different namespaces. So now we need to access these public members from this namespace. Here I'll create object for point class, point. Here we are unable to get point class. Now what we need to do? Here point comes under C# tutorial namespace. We need to mention namespace name dot class name. Here C# tutorial dot. Now we are able to get point and program classes. We'll create object for point class, p equal to new point p dot. Here we are able to get x and y variables. How we are accessing these members means x and y declared as a public. we can access public members from anywhere. Here, these public members were accessing within the assembly. In the future videos, we'll access these members from other assembly. What we discuss in this video is, if we declare any member as public, then that member we can access inside class or from other classes or from other namespace class. Here, we declare this member as public, then this public field we can access within this class or other classes within the assembly or other classes from other assembly. That's it for today. If you like this video, please share with your friends and subscribe to my YouTube channel for future videos. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.